Hey everyone, it's Michael Antonovich with Swap Moto Live. After a much needed weekend off, we've returned to Florida for the 2021 Daytona Supercross. It's hard to think of a better place for the Monster Energy Supercross Series to return to action than Daytona. The facility itself is historical, it's the longest running venue in the yearly calendar, and the track that Ricky Carmichael and crew come up with is a challenge that riders have to deal with every single lap. Saturday night's race will be the halfway point in the 17-round tour, and since so many believe the phrase, the championship starts at Daytona, we can expect close racing throughout the field. With that, let's jump into a few key details about the 2021 Daytona Supercross in this SML News Break presented by Fly Racing. The most significant factor of the weekend will be the weather. Saturday's forecast looks a little grim, with storms predicted to roll through Florida from midday all the way into the evening. It's a shame, too, because the weather during Friday's media session was picture perfect, and Saturday looks like it could be the only wet day of bike week. The track crew made changes to the course layout in anticipation of the rain, as they didn't soak the dirt down before Friday's demo laps and remove some of the deep gator pit elements that we're used to seeing at Daytona. The grass infield, dark dirt, and beach sand can hold plenty of moisture, so right now, all anyone can do is wait and see what race day brings. A handful of riders have confirmed that they will be absent from Daytona's starting line due to ongoing injuries and issues. Zach Osborne has decided to sit the race out due to a bulging disc in his lower back, an injury the Rockstar Energy Husqvarna factory racing rider suffered between the Orlando events. Per a talk I had with the team today, Osborne tried to manage the issue, but it was too much to deal with going into Daytona, and they will now turn their attention to a possible return at Arlington. 2018 Daytona main event winner Justin Brayton will also be sidelined. The Muckoff Honda rider had a practice crash before Orlando 2, took a massive hit to the chest, and is still too sore to risk racing. The team will have Mitchell Oldenburg subbing for JB10 in the 450 class. Adam Cincirillo is out due to a broken collarbone, the first of a few races that the Monster Energy Kawasaki rider is expected to miss. Although AC is out, his training partner Chase Sexton will use Daytona as his return to action with Team Honda HRC. The Martin brothers had a very rough opening round in Orlando, and as expected, only one of them will be back in Daytona. Manluck, Rock River Yamaha Merge Racing's Alex Martin passed the concussion protocol and has been cleared to return, but a dislocated shoulder will keep Monster Energy Star Racing Yamaha's Jeremy Martin out of action for an undetermined amount of time. The Troy Lee Designs Red Bull Gas Gas Factory Racing team will have two riders in the 250 class this weekend, as Pierce Brown is back following a long recovery from a knee injury, and Ryan Sipes will make his customary appearance at the Speedway. Like we said at the start, Daytona will be the halfway point in the championship for the 450 class. Ken Roczen and Cooper Webb have established themselves as the key contenders for the title, thanks to three main event wins each and a slew of podium finishes that they've scored, and 6 points separate the two rivals at the top of the standings. Eli Tomac has not been as strong as we expected this season, but the defending champion has not completely lost hope on the title. Already a four-time victor at Daytona, another successful Saturday night would help Tomac close the 31-point gap that Roczen has built, and would tie Tomac with Ricky Carmichael as the venue's all-time winner. We're excited to see the 2021 Daytona Supercross unfold, so as always, follow along on our social media accounts and our website, swapmotolive.com, for the latest updates from the track. Talk to you soon.